sea witch? Why, that's... I couldn't possibly. No! Get out of here! Leave me alone!
Suit yourself. That was only a suggestion.
Wait.
Yes?
Poor Ariel.
I didn't mean to tell. It was an accident. Ariel, where are you going? Ariel, what are you doing here with this riffraff?
I'm going to see Ursula.
Ariel, no! No, she's a demon! She's a monster!
Why don't you go tell my father? You're good at that.
But I... Come on!
This way! Come in. Come in, my child. We mustn't lurk in doorways. It's rude. One might question your upbringing. Now, then, you're here because you have a thing for this human, this prince fellow. Not that I blame you. He is quite a catch, isn't he? Well, angelfish, the solution to your problem is simple. The only way to get what you want is to become a human yourself.
Can you do that?
My dear, sweet child, that's what I do. It's what I live for, to help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light, and made a switch. 2 years. And I fortunately knew a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And here lately, please don't laugh, I use it on behalf of the miserable, lonely, and depressed. Pathetic. Poor, unfortunate souls in pain, in need. This one longing to be thinner, that one wants to get the girl, and do I help them? Yes, indeed. Those poor, unfortunate souls, so sad, so true. They come flocking to my cauldron, crying, spells, Ursula, please, and I help them. Yes, I do. Now it's happened once or twice. Someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I had to rake them across the coals. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole, I've been a saint. To those poor, unfortunate souls. Now, here's the deal. I will make you a potion that will turn you into a human for 3 days. Got that? 3 days. Now listen, this is important. Before the sun sets on the third day, you've got to get dear old Princey to fall in love with you. That is, he's got to kiss you. Not just any kiss. The kiss of true love. If he does kiss you before the sun sets on the third day, you'll remain human permanently. But if he doesn't, you turn back into a mermaid, and you belong to me.
No, Ariel!
Have we got a deal?
If I become human, I'll never be with my father or sisters again.
That's right. But you'll have your man. Life's full of tough choices, isn't it? Oh, and there is one more thing. We haven't discussed the subject of payment. You can't get something for nothing, you know.
But I don't have
it. I'm not asking much. Just a token, really, a trifle. You'll never even miss it. What I want from you is... your voice.
My voice?
You've got it, sweet cakes. No more talking, singing, zip.
But without my voice... how can I...
You'll have your looks, your pretty face. And don't underestimate the importance of a body language. Ha! The men up there don't like a lot of blabber. They think a girl who gossips is a bore. Yet on land it's much preferred for ladies not to say a word. And after all, dear, what is idle prattle for? Come on, then, not all that impressed with conversation. True gentlemen avoid it when they can. But they dote in swoon and fawn on a lady who's withdrawn. It's she who holds her tongue who gets a man. Come on, you poor unfortunate soul. Go ahead, make your choice. I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much, just your voice. Your poor unfortunate soul. It's sad, but true. If you want to cross a bridge, my sweet, you've got to pay the toll. Take a gulp and take a breath and go ahead and sign the scroll. Flotsam jetsam, now I've got her, boys. The boss is on a roll. This poor Savruga, come winds of the Caspian Sea. La Rhenus, Glossitis, Ajax, Laryngitis, La Voce to me. Keep singing!
That voice. I can't get it out of my head. I've looked everywhere, Max. Where could she be?
Well, look at what the catfish dragged in. Look at you. Look at you. There's something different. Don't tell me. I got it. It's your hairdo, right? You've been using a Dinglehopper, right? No? No, huh? Well, let me see. New seashells? No new seashells. I gotta admit, I can't put my foot on it right now, but if I just stand here long enough, I know
she's
that I'll...
She's got legs, you idiot! She traded her vice to the sea witch and got legs. Jeez, man.
I knew that.
Ariel's been turned into a human. She's gonna make the prince fall in love with her, and he's gonna kiss her.
And she's only got 3 days. Just look at her! On legs! On human legs! My nerves are shot. This is a catastrophe! What would our father say? I'll tell you what our father'd say. He'd say he's gonna kill himself a crab. That's what our father'd say. I'm gonna march myself straight home right now and tell him just like I could have done the minute. And don't you shake your head at me, young lady. Maybe there's still time. If we could get that witch to give you back your voice, you could go home with all the normal fish and just be miserable for the rest of your life. All right. I'll try to help you find that prince. Boy, what a soft shell I'm turning out to be.
Now, Ariel, I'm telling you, if you want to be a human, the first thing you gotta do is dress like one. Now, let me see.
Max? What? Huh? What? Max!
You look great, kid. You look sensational.
Max! Max! Quiet, Max! What's gotten into you, fella? Oh. Oh, I see.